Bible story, Busy Ants, Wise Ants. Tick-tack, tippity-tap, the ants were marching, marching, marching. The ants were marching over warm brown sand. Tick-tack, tippity-tap, the ants were marching, marching, marching. The ants were marching past the tall green grass. Tick, tack, tip, suddenly, an ant stopped. Right in front of the ant was something big and yellow. The ant looked up, up, up at the big yellow object thing. What could it be? Was it a balloon? Was it a ball? The object was not quite round, yet it was not quite square. The object must be a kernel grain of corn. Swish, swash, swish, all the ants swarmed around the big yellow kernel of corn. Whoosh! The ants lifted up the big kernel of corn, all working together. The ants were very, very strong. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants began to march home. The ants wobbled from side to side as they carried the big kernel of corn. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched over the sand. The ants marched past the tall green grass. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched right up ant hill. They marched to the very top. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched to a big dark hole on the top of the hill. It was the tunnel to Ant City. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched down into the tunnel until they reached Ant City. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched into Ant City carrying the big yellow kernel of corn. It was a special treasure. The big yellow kernel of corn was a food treasure for Ant City. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched every day for many, many days. They march in the hot sun. They march in the wet rain. The ants march everywhere looking for more food treasures. The ants march in the spring. The ants march in the summer. The ants march in the fall. One day, as the ants were marching, they began to shiver. Ooh, the sun no longer felt warm. The air was very, very cool. Tick-tack, tippity-tap. The ants marched much, much faster. They were trying to stay warm. Splat! Something fell in front of the ants. It was soft. It was wet and cold. Splat! Something fell behind the ants. That something was also soft, wet, and cold. Splat, splat! Those somethings were snowflakes. It was starting to snow. Tickety-tack! The ants hurried back to the ant hill as fast as they could hurry. Skippity-skat! The ants scurried up ant hill as fast as they could scurry. Zippity-zap! The ants scooted down the tunnel until they reached Ant City. Quickly, the ants scampered into Ant City. There was no snow falling in Ant City at all. Ant City was snug and warm. Splat, splat! The snow kept falling outside. It fell all day. The snow covered tiny grains of sand. The snow covered tall green blades of grass. Finally, the snow-covered anthill. Even the door to the tunnel could not be seen. The ants could not leave Ant City. They could not look for food treasures. The ants could not gather any more food. Yet, the ants were not afraid. The ants were not afraid at all. In Ant City, there were already many, many food treasures. There were big yellow kernels of corn. There were green leaves, purple grapes, and big brown breadcrumbs. Why? Ant City was full of yummy, yummy ant food. Aren't you glad that the ants went marching for food treasures each day? The ants did not sit in the cool shade. The ants hunted for food in the warm spring sun. They hunted for food in the hot summer sun. They hunted for food in the cool fall sun. God's word tells us something very important about ants. Ants do not have someone who says, "Hurry up, find food." There are no ant paces that read, "It's going to snow." God made ants very special. God made ants to gather food. Ants do not even have to think about it. The ants obey. The ants obey God. God made each one of us special too. God made us to obey Him. God knows what we need. God knows how to take care of each one of us.